Hi, thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm meteorologist Josh Judge with a look at the top wind gusts we saw today. Check out Whitefield, 51 miles per hour, and many strong wind gusts elsewhere around the state as well. It remains windy through the nighttime hours. That wind chill factor in effect. It'll feel very cold first thing in the morning with temperatures feeling like they're either side of zero. Actual temperatures in southern New Hampshire will be probably in the teens. But as you head farther north, as you can see, it feels like it's between 10 and 20 below zero. First thing tomorrow morning, gets a little better, but another cold day, as you can see, throughout the entire day tomorrow. Here's one last look at all that rain and snow that rolled on through. Clearing skies followed behind it, except for the mountains, where some clouds and snow showers have been around for a time. All thanks to this area of high pressure that brought in the wind. And it also is bringing in colder temperatures as that storm system pulls away. That tightens up over the ocean as it strengthens. The difference between that low pressure and this area of high pressure building in, that's what's causing the wind a little bit longer. And then the wind subsides by the time we get to about Friday, but something else happens on Friday. I'll show you in a moment as well. Here's that cold air wrapping around the area of high pressure, coming down to really chill things down for a couple of days below average temperatures. Haven't seen a whole lot of that this season. And we've got clouds in the mountains, which hang around for a while thanks to the winds out of the northwest bumping into those mountains. A few more snow showers or flurries possible at times in far northern New Hampshire, especially on those northern and east western slopes. But the clouds and the snow showers kind of go by the wayside overnight into early tomorrow. And then tomorrow we all see a lot of sunshine, maybe a few clouds around northern New Hampshire here and there, just decorative. Everywhere else it should be blue skies. I mentioned Friday. There it is. Watch this storm system roll on through, really strengthening as it does so on the day Friday, but missing us to the south with the exception of possibly some flurries or snow showers across the southern part of the state. A look at your lows tonight. As I mentioned, the cold air coming in, these do not include the wind chill, feeling like it's around zero to below zero to the north. Single digits and teens everywhere else, and we don't recover all that much tomorrow. Highs between about 20 and 30 from the White Mountains on southward, and in northern New Hampshire, you're just barely getting into the teens. And how about a look at Friday? I mentioned there could be some flurries or snow showers in southern New Hampshire. That storm misses us to the south, maybe a degree or two milder, but that's about it. Northern New Hampshire could see some breaks of sunshine. A look at your week ahead reveals something interesting. After below average temperatures the next couple of days and a pretty average and nice weekend ahead with a lot of sunshine and temperatures right around where you'd expect this time of year, things really change as a warm front comes through around Monday. And look at the warmer temperatures that we'll be seeing as we head into next week. And that is your forecast. Stay warm and thanks for joining us here.